Moving on, state elections in the Indian state of Nagaland are just a week away. Political editor Karthikeya Sharma spoke to Congress star campaigner Gaurav Gogoi in the run-up to the elections.
Election campaign in Nagaland is in its last phase. I'm joined by star campaigner and also a member of parliament, Gaurav Gogoi, who is in Dimapur right now with me. Gaurav, what's the Congress strategy and as to why Congress party is only contesting 18 seats in Nagaland?
Well, first of all, the Congress strategy is to appeal to the people of Nagaland to heed to the call of the church, which is a powerful institution in the state of Nagaland. And this, the church has called for a clean election. We are going out to the people to say that clean election means an election where we can form a secular government, where we can bring in parties that respect all communities and of all faiths. Secondly, when it comes to the question of candidates, yes, Congress has fielded 18 candidates, but you see that except for NPF, nobody has fielded candidates in all seats. NPF, the regional party, is the only one. Yet, Congress is active in each and every village and each and every district. So while we are having 18 candidates and 18 prospective MLAs, we are reaching out in all 60 seats through our party workers, telling the people that let us not allow communal forces such as the BJP and RSS to enter. Let us not allow a party like the NDPP to play the role of a Trojan horse and allow BJP RSS a backdoor entry into Nagaland to vitiate the culture and unique identity of the Nagas.
But a lot of people would say that the church has taken a political position, a religious institution has politicized the election by actually writing letters to political parties.
I think those who are not familiar with the history of Nagaland and the role of the church in the state of Nagaland would make such statements. The church is a very respectable institution, has always appealed to young people to go out and vote consciously, has always appealed to the people to vote in the favor of development. And I think today, if the church is issuing a message of peace and secularism and development, I don't see anything wrong. After all, that is the fabric of Indian culture.